By now, you probably already know how to customize Pipedrive with stages that match your process, or you've added special fields to your deals and contacts to track information that's more consistent with your business. Already a good start, but even the best of us could use some time-saving tips and tricks that'll make your job a lot easier. So let's talk about how to get more out of Pipedrive. For starters, when it comes to your pipelines and stages, think of your stages as a continuous process, and while stages tell you where the deal is at in the process, it doesn't represent the actual status of the deal per se. For example, a common mistake we see is having one stage called customer contacted and another stage called customer not engaged. Now, what we suggest you do is to follow the process only with customers you've contacted, and those you've not been successful with, well, just go ahead and mark that deal as lost, using no answer or no response or something like that as your reason. Remember, you can customize your lost reasons in Pipedrive. By doing this, you'll not only have a cleaner pipeline, but now you're kind of categorizing these people as unengaged, so if you wanted to engage them later and maybe create some campaigns or something like that, you can even use workflow automation for something like that, but we'll get to that in just a minute. Another tip for the meantime is to be sure that you're setting up your custom fields for the right profiles. Remember, you can set up custom fields for deals, leads, people, organizations, and your products. For example, this custom field for tracking the industry of your contact organizations will always be the same, and it doesn't really change from deal to deal. On the other hand, this field that's tracking the source which this deal came from may change because at one moment a customer may search for you and find your website and start negotiation A, but at another moment, the same customer might find you through social media and start negotiation B. So in this case, it's preferable to track the source of this negotiation from the deals section. It's more temporary in nature. Now, another tip you may not be aware of is the level of permissions and visibility to your company data that you can configure in the manage users section. It's here you can not only invite more people to join your Pipedrive account, but you can grant or restrict access to a multitude of permissions. Now, another area of Pipedrive you can get more value out of is the insights section, basically your dashboards and reports. And if fine-tuned for your needs, it can be a major motivator as well as a reporting tool for you or your team. You'll notice that you have a report section, a goal section, and a dashboard section. You could start off by selecting any of the reports already here or creating your own new report. And after you're done configuring and filtering the data that you see in this report specifically for what you and your industry needs, you can then add this report to your dashboard. Because your dashboard acts as sort of a collection of all the reports that you make. You can reorganize the order the reports appear, the size they appear, and you can even run quick filters on your dashboard right here. So say you wanted to see the results of this same dashboard for just one single user. But once you feel confident with the dashboard you've built, you can share it with anyone you'd like via this Share Dashboard button here. And later on, you can even revoke access to some people while still allowing access to others. Now that we understand a little bit more some ways to set up our reporting, let's talk about ways we can automate some mundane data entry and repetitive administrative tasks. Using workflow automation, you can ideally shave off a whole lot of time and keep yourself focused on the things that really matter. Because say you find yourself always scheduling the same follow-up activity every time you move a deal into a specific stage, you can automate that, yo. Time is the most valuable resource we have, after all. Pipedrive's workflow automation templates help you preserve this resource by making it even easier to automate certain tasks for your sales process. To learn more about workflow automation, just check out the link in this video. Now let's talk about leads and lead qualification for a second here. Some of you may be wondering, what's the difference between a lead and a deal, right? To put it simply, leads are less qualified than deals, or less important, shall we say. If you have a vast list of leads to get into Pipedrive, then you might want to start off with, well, leads. And deals are what you would drag and drop through the stages of your pipelines. And they have, overall, a whole lot more functionality than leads do, such as the sales docs feature with e-signatures. You can also perform activities and qualify leads in your list and then later convert them to deals when things are getting more serious, and this keeps your pipeline neat and focused on the prospects that are really important every time you log in. So the leads inbox is free for everyone, but additionally you can get the Web Visitors add-on and the LeadBooster add-on, which includes several tools for lead generation and qualification. First, let's talk about LeadBooster. Part of LeadBooster is the chatbot. Just tailor the chatbot's questions and responses to your needs, according to the different web pages you would have. And depending on the visitor's answers, it will qualify them immediately and route them to your sales reps. Chatbot, as well as the rest of these lead generation and qualification tools, can technically qualify and create leads in your leads inbox or deals in your sales pipelines. Now, speaking of the chatbot, another feature related to it is our live chat feature. Live chat can be inserted into any step of the chatbot flow, so depending on the responses your customers give, they can request a chat from your team. Whoever is marked as available either in the Pipedrive desktop app or mobile app will be immediately notified when someone would like to chat, so nobody ever misses one. Then there's our Prospector, which finds your next new lead from a database of over 400 million profiles based on your ideal customer persona. So this means that you can now target your company's or product's specific demographic and generate contact data for yourself and your teams. All you gotta do is create a filter according to what you need. The Prospector uses credits to reveal these verified emails and direct dial phone numbers and social profiles and such. So now you'll never run out of business opportunities. Then let's talk about the Web Visitors add-on. You could use this to discover companies from your website traffic that previously may have been unconverted or anonymous, shall we say. The Web Visitors add-on will identify how they found you, what they engaged with, and how long they stayed for. So ideally, you can then use these metrics to optimize your site's content and tailor your outreach to your new leads or existing customers. This kind of helps you anticipate what their needs are before you even make contact, for example. And that can go a long way. And while we're at it, what if you happen to have a favorite integration that you'd like to connect with Pipedrive? Just head on over to the Pipedrive Marketplace, because we're growing our list and checking it twice. So we do hope this video has helped you discover a few new ways of using Pipedrive. Have a good one, Pipedrivers.